video, I'll continue with words and streams. I'll discuss some more formula that are required to solve problems on words and streams and some more problems based on those formula. So in my previous video, I have discussed about the speed of boat, speed of stream, downstream speed, upstream speed, all these. So we have taken the speed of boat in still water as x kilometer per hour and speed of stream as y kilometer per hour. That is when we consider a boat going on a stream and the speed of stream is y kilometer per hour. If the boat is going along the direction of the stream, then we call it the boat is going downstream. The downstream speed is equal to the sum of the speed of these two. That is, downstream speed is equal to x plus y kilometer per hour. On the other hand, if the boat is moving in the direction opposite to the direction of the stream, then we call it as upstream. And the upstream speed is given by x minus y kilometer per hour. Now, if the time taken to cover a distance of d kilometer downstream is t1 hours, and if the time taken to cover the same distance upstream is t2 hours, then from these two, we will calculate the total time and the average speed. Now, we know that speed is equal to distance by time. So, from here we can write time is equal to distance by speed. Now, the time taken to cover d kilometer downstream is t1 hours. Then, t1 will be equal to d divided by downstream speed. Downstream speed is x plus y. So, t1 is equal to d divided by x plus y. And t2 will be equal to d divided by x minus y, because the time taken to cover distance d kilometer upstream is t2 hours. Then t2 will be equal to d by upstream speed. Upstream speed is x minus y. So we have total time. Then total time will be t1 plus t2. So this is equal to d by x plus y plus d by x minus y. So this is equal to d into x minus y plus x plus y divided by x plus y into x minus y. So here minus y will go, plus y minus y will go. So we get t1 plus t2 as d into 2x by x plus y into x minus y. So the average speed is given by, let me continue in the next page. So the total distance covered, it is nothing but it is equal to 2d, and the total time taken is equal to d into 2x divided by x plus y into x minus y. This we have calculated just now. Then we know that the average speed is equal to total distance by total time. So this is equal to total distance is 2d divided by total time is d into 2x by x plus y into x minus y. So this is equal to 2d by d into 2x into x plus y into x minus y. So this 2 will go, this t will go. So this is equal to x plus y into x minus y divided by x. Here x plus y is nothing but it is the upstream speed, x minus y is the downstream speed, and x is the speed of boat in still water. So the average speed, we have got it as x plus y into x minus y by x. This we can write it as x square minus y square by x. I hope this is clear. So we have got the average speed is equal to x plus y into x minus y by x, which is equal to x square minus y square by x. So the average speed is equal to downstream speed into upstream speed divided by speed in still water. So this is the formula to calculate average speed. Now we'll see a problem. The problem says a boat rows a distance of 12 km downstream at 13 km per hour and covers the same distance upstream at 7 km per hour. Find the average speed of the boat. So we just now saw the formula to calculate average speed is equal to upstream speed, that is x plus y into x minus y divided by x. That is, it is the product of upstream speed and the downstream speed upon the speed in still water. Here we are given the downstream speed, we are given the upstream speed also, but we do not know the speed in still water. This, to find the speed in still water, we can calculate from the downstream speed and the upstream speed. So we are given the downstream speed u is equal to x plus y is equal to 13 km per hour, and v, that is the upstream speed, is equal to x minus y is equal to 7 km per hour. So if we add 1 and 2, let us mark this as equation 1 and 2. So if we add these two equations, then we will get x plus y plus x minus y. So this plus y and minus y will cancel. We will be left with 2x is equal to 13 plus 7, or 2x is equal to 20. From this we get x is equal to 20 by 2, that is 10 km per hour. Now we can find the average speed very easily. We can substitute here and we can find the average speed. You know what is x plus y, what is x minus y, and we have found x. So average speed is equal to x plus y is 13, x minus y is 7. Here x plus y is 13, x minus y is 7. So 13 into 7 divided by x. X we have got 10. So 13 into 7 divided by 10. This is equal to 91 by 10, which is equal to 9.1 kilometers per. So the average speed of the boat is 9.1 kilometers per hour. Now we will solve the remaining questions of exercise 1.4 from chapter 1 of Applied Mathematics by M.L. Agarwal. So the 10th question is, a man can row at 8 km in still water. If the speed of the current is 2 km per hour and he takes 4 hours to row to a place and return back, how far is the place? So here we have the speed of the man in still water is 8, speed of the current is 2 km per hour, and he takes 4 hours to row to a place and return back. So the total time is given. Now we have to calculate how far is the place. So we have to find d, that is the distance d. We are given total time t is equal to 4 hours, that is t1 plus t2 is equal to 4 hours. Then we are given the speed of the man in still water. The speed of the boat in still water x is 8 km per hour, and the speed of the current y is 2 km per hour. So we have all the information except So from this x and y we can find the average speed, and from the average speed we can find this d. So we know that average speed is equal to total distance by total time. So for average speed, we know the formula. It is x plus y into x minus y by x is equal to total distance. It is 2d by total time is t1 plus t2. So from this relation, we can find d. Find the value of d. So we have x is 8, y is 2. So 8 plus 2 into 8 minus 2 divided by 8 is equal to 2d divided by t1 plus t2 is 4. So the total time is given as 4 hours. So t1 plus t2 is equal to 4. So let me continue here. So from this we have d by 2 is equal to 8 plus 2 is 10. 8 minus 2 is 6 divided by 8. So here we can simplify this. So we get d is equal to 2 into 5 into 3 divided by 2. This 2 will go. So this is 15. So d is equal to 15 kilometer. So how far is the place they have asked? So we have found the distance d. D is equal to 15 kilometer. Next question. The speed of a boat in still water is 12 km per hour and the speed of the stream is 2 km per hour. A person rows to a place at a distance of 70 km and returns back to the starting point. Find the total time taken by him. So in the previous question, they gave the total time and asked the distance. Here they have given the distance and they are asking the total time. So we can use the same formula, average speed formula. Here we have to find the total time, that is to find t1 plus t. So what are all given? The speed of boat in still water is given as 12 km per hour. The speed of the stream is given as 2 km per hour and the distance is given as 70 kilometers. So we know that the average speed is equal to total distance by total time. Total distance by total time. We know the formula for average speed. The formula for average speed is x plus y into x minus y divided by x is equal to total distance is 2d divided by total time. Now let us take t1 plus t2 as t divided by t. So let us substitute all the values. X it is given as 12 plus y is 2. So 12 plus 2 into 12 minus 2 divided by 12 is equal to 2 into 70 by t. Or 12 plus 2 is 14 into 10 by 12 is equal to 2 into 70 by t. Let us simplify this. This is 6, 5, again into, we divide by 2, 3, 7. So we get t is equal to, let us cross multiply, 2 into 70 into 3 divided by 7 into 5. Now let us again simplify. This will go 70 by 7 is 10. 10 by 5 is
2.
So this is equal to 12. So we have got the total time t is equal to 12 hours. So therefore, total time is equal to 12 hours. Next question, a boat goes 30 km downstream and comes back to the starting point in 4 hours 30 minutes. If the speed of the boat in still water is 15 km per hour, find the speed of the stream. So here they have given the distance and the time, and they have given the speed of boat in still water. We have to find the speed of stream. So here we have given all information except y. Again, we can use average speed formula. So what are all given? We have to find speed of stream. So to find y, that is the speed of stream. They have given d as 30 km and the total time t as 4 hours 30 minutes. 4 hours 30 minutes, that is equal to 4 plus 30 minutes is half an hour. So this is equal to 9 by 2 hours. Then they have given the speed of boat in still water. X is equal to 15 km per hour. So we have to find, we know the formula for average speed. Average speed is equal to total distance by total time. By total time, average speed we know x plus y into x minus y by x is equal to 2d by t. So from this we can calculate y. So let us write x plus y into x minus y as x square minus y square divided by x is equal to 2 into 30 divided by 9 by 2. So x we know x is 15. So 15 square minus y square divided by 15 is equal to 2 by 9 into 2 into 30. So let us simplify. Here we have 10. And this 3 and 15 will go 5 times. So 15 square is 225 minus y square is equal to, here 2 into 2, 4 into 10, 40, 40 into 5. So from this we get 225 minus, let me bring it this side, 40 into 5 is 200. Is equal to y square, or we get y square is equal to 225 minus 200, that is 25, which is equal to 5 square. If we take square root on both sides, we will get y is equal to 5. So the speed of the stream is 5 km per hour. I hope this is clear. We just have to use the average speed formula. Substitute all the values and from that we can find y. Now we will see another formula for distance. Here, if a boat takes t hours more in going upstream than downstream, and if the distance travelled upstream is equal to distance travelled downstream is equal to d. When we have this case, then we can find the value for t. The usual notation which we use is the time required to travel downstream, we take it as t1. T1 is equal to distance by the downstream speed, that is x plus y. And t2, we take it as the time required to travel upstream, t2 is equal to d by x minus y. Here it is given that a boat takes t hours more in going upstream than downstream. So it is given t is equal to t2 minus t1. So this is equal to t2 is d by x minus y minus of d by x plus y. T is equal to t into x plus y minus x minus of minus y is plus y divided by x minus y into x plus y. So here x minus x will go. So we have t is equal to d into 2y divided by x plus y into x minus y. So from this we get d is equal to, when we cross multiply, we get d is equal to t into x plus y into x minus y divided by 2y. So this is the distance, that is when the distance traveled upstream is equal to distance traveled downstream, and if the boat takes t hours more in going upstream than downstream, then we get d is equal to t into x plus y into x minus y by 2y. Or we can even simplify, this is equal to t into x square minus y square by 2y. So as we got, we have d is equal to t into x plus y into x minus y by 2y, which is equal to t into x square minus y square by 2y, where y is the speed of the stream, x is the speed of boat in still water, and t is the extra time taken in going upstream than downstream. Now we'll continue the next question. A boat takes 90 minutes less to travel 36 kilometers downstream than to travel the same distance upstream. If the speed of the boat in still water is 10 km per hour, find the speed of the stream. So here it is given a boat takes 90 minutes less to travel downstream than upstream. That is, we are given t2 minus t1, the extra time is 90 minutes. And the distance is given as 36 kilometers. We have given the speed of boat in still water as 10 kilometer. We have to find the speed of the stream. So we can directly use the formula which we just now saw. So first let us write what the given information. We are given t, that is the extra time taken to travel upstream, is 90 minutes. Let us convert this to hours, is equal to 90 by 60, or it is equal to 3 by 2 hours. Then they have given the distance is 36 kilometers. And the speed of boat in still water, x is 10 kilometer per hour. We have to find y to find the speed of the stream. So we know the formula for d. D is equal to t into x square minus y square by 2y. We just now saw the formula, so let us use that formula. So we are given d. D is 36 is equal to, t is given as 3 by 2 into x square is 10 square minus y square divided by 2y. So let me write it this side. So 36 into 4y by 3 is equal to 100 minus y square. So this will be 12 Now we have got a quadratic equation in y. So we get y square minus, y square plus 48y minus 100 is equal to 0. We know how to solve a quadratic equation. It is very easy. So we have y square, this 48 we can write it as plus 50 minus 2. So plus 50y minus 2y minus 100 is equal to 0. Or here y into y plus 50 minus 2 into y plus 50 is equal to 0. From this we get y minus 2 into y plus 50 is equal to 0. So we have y is equal to 2 or y is equal to minus 50. Since y is the speed of stream, it cannot be negative. So y is not equal to, we cannot take y is equal to minus 50. So we have the speed of stream as 2 km per hour. So this is the speed of stream. I hope this is clear. The next question. A man rows to a place at a distance of 48 km and returns back in 14 hours. He finds that he can row 4 km with the stream in the same time as 3 km against the stream. Find the speed of stream. So we are asked to find the speed of stream. Y. Here it is given. A man rows to a place at a distance of 48 km and returns back in 14 hours. So using this we can find the average speed, and we will have some relation between x and y. Then we will use the next information given and let us find the speed of stream. So we are given distance is 48 km and total time, that is t1 plus t2 is given as 14 hours. We are asked to find the speed of, first let us use the average speed formula. Average speed is equal to total distance by total time. Total distance divided by total time. So average speed, we know it is equal to x square minus y square by x. This is equal to total distances 2 into 48 divided by total time is 14 hours. So let us simplify this. So we have x square minus y square is equal to 48 by 7, yes. Let us mark this as 1 and let us have it. Then we have another information which is given. He finds that he can row 4 km with the stream in the same time as 3 km against the stream. So here time for 4 km downstream is equal to time taken for 3 km upstream. This is what is given. So we know that time is given by distance by speed. So here 4 divided by downstream speed, that is x plus y, is equal to 3 divided by upstream speed, x minus y. From this we can find x. So we have 4x minus 4y is equal to 3x plus 3y. Or we have 4x minus 3x, x is equal to 7y. So we have got two equations and two variables. We can easily find y. So let us substitute 2 in 1. So let us substitute 2 in 1. We get x square is 7y the whole square minus y square is equal to 48 by 7 into x is 7y. So 7y square is 49y square minus y square is equal to, here these two will go, 48y. 49y square minus y square is nothing but 48y square minus 48y is equal to 0, or we have 48y into y minus 1 is equal to 0. From this we get y is equal to 1 or y is equal to 0. Here y is not equal to 0. Therefore, y is equal to 1. Therefore, the speed of stream is 1 kilometer per hour. So, therefore, y is equal to 1 kilometer per hour. I hope this is clear. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching.